Welcome back to my channel. Today I will show you how to use upscale images and videos in ComfyUI workflow. First, you start the ComfyUI server, and it will take a few minutes, depends on how many nodes you already installed and what is your setting in the batch file. I kept option in ComfyUI startup batch file, like whenever it run, it will check for the ComfyUI repository updates. So in my case, it will take some time, and I have near about 60 plus nodes installed. But in your case, it might be faster, as you might have less nodes in mind. So let's few seconds more to let it start up. If you're new user ComfyUI and don't know how to install it, you can follow my YouTube video and channel. I will provide a link below. Now ComfyUI server already started locally. Now we can design the workflow here by double click here, or can drag drop an existing workflow from your hard drive. I will drag and drop one workflow here, which will generate text to image normal first and upscale that image to 4K using model. This workflow is very simple. We will use some checkpoint model and VA most common model and use 4X ultra scale model. Load upscale model is a node. If it's not installed in your ComfyUI server, you have to install it. After you install the node, there will one upscale model folder automatically created, and you can download and save the upscale models there by download load from ComfyUI Manager and find the model by typing upscale, or can download from Hugging Face. Let's select the upscale model and try to run the workflow. Here have many models I had downloaded before. Most of the cases are the extension of the upscale it.pth. Let's set the other models of the workflow, like Checkpoint, where I always prefer models like Dream Shaper or Epic Realism, which produce natural style images. And when you upscale the image, you can easily identify the difference. At the same, to set the VA model also, I will use the most commonly used VA model. After checking every parameters, it's time to run the workflow. For run the workflow in Windows, press F5 or Q button. It will start processing node by node and generate two images. One is normal and one upscale image. As this workflow is running first time after ComfyUI server started, so it will take some time, but from the next time process will be a little bit faster. First, it will load the checkpoint and then VA and follow the text to image prompt and generate the image based on the size or resolution provided. Then it will upscale the same image to 4K image. I want to check the process of backend of ComfyUI server from command window. It's a 20 steps workflow, so wait and see the results. And here you go output you can see here. Let's open the both images in preview window and check the results, and here's the results. If you have any low quality images, that will be best for check this workflow. If you like this video, please subscribe my channel and watch till end, as many more to come. Let's try another workflow for upscale. I will show you image and video upscaling. Let's start with image upscale. I have some workflow where you will upload any image and type text and select the upscale model and run the workflow. It's a very basic workflow and you have nothing to worry. I will share the link for this workflow as usual in my description box. There are many kind of upscale models, but today we will check 4K upscale. If you don't have model for upscale, you can download it from ComfyUI Manager. You can search in Hugging Face also to get the upscale model. 8K upscale model is a payable option. If you want, you can use that also. By the text box, I give in text prompt that the man is smiling. So when this image will be upscaled, this man should have a smile face. Let's run the workflow from Q button. For the first time, it might take some time as model need to load in the memory. Now it's running and follow the nodes and processing images by sampler, and it will show the result soon. And here's the result. Looks cool, right? Let's upload another image and check the results. You can try any upscale model as per your choices. I will try the same kind of image, so it's smile, as I will not change the prompt, but you can try different prompts or try and get the results. You can try with lady image also to forget more impressive results. After few seconds, you will see the results. And here you go and see this man also have a smiley face. And here's the results. Let's start a new upscale workflow where I will show you how to upscale image using ControlNet. Here, this workflow will use same text image using same Dream Shaper model and VA model like same I used in the last video. This workflow also a text image workflow, so there'll be prompt and negative prompt. You can use any prompt as per your choice. I will use the same upscale model here, and as I put Cyberpunk Cat. So I want to use Line Control Net. This workflow is basically control image by upscale and control net model. There are many types of control net model, which use to do different things. Later part of this video, I will show you how you can control the images by pose and some drawing image and insert some text to generate and control or generate the images based on that. I will discuss and show it shortly. Let's position and rearrange the node a little bit and then run the workflow. To run the workflow, it's same, either press F5 key or click on Q button. So let's click on Q button for run this workflow. Within a few seconds, it will generate the first part of the image and it will upscale the image, but following the model control net. I will process the image finally by last case sampler, and finally the output will come out within a few seconds. So just wait until it's finished the process. And here you go, and you saw image generated. Now it's time to open the preview and check the both images so you can compare. Right click and select open image, and it will open the new windows and give you a full preview of the image. Open another image also, and you will see that the far hair in the face, it more clear in face of the cat. So actually it's upscaled and follow control net model to show more details of the image. I hope you understand how control net works. Now you can save the workflow if you want. Let's move to the next workflow, which is another control net workflow. But in this workflow, we will use pose and sketch, which we can't draw fully, but can imagine and type the text to image prompt for generate the image of character, who will follow the pose, and control net will help to generate image and force character to follow that pose. Very interesting, right? I provided some text here for generate the character, and I will select the Dream Shaper model again for generate the character and image. In the left side's upload image control, you can upload the control net's pose. I will provide the link from where you can get many control net poses. And you can draw any sketch image in Paint or can check from Google also by searching sketch images. Then upload it as second image. Here is negative prompt also. It's always advisable that you change the color or positive and negative prompt node when you run or save any workflow before that, as I want to control the pose of the character. So let me choose the Open Pose Control Net model. If you not find any Open Pose model, then you can download the model from Comfy UI Manager. But sometimes you will not get some model by manager. Then you have search on Hugging Face or other places to search the model. As we want to control pose and wants to generate our imaginary sketch by Control Net. So I will have to use another Control Net model named Scribble Control Net, which will convert my sketch to image. So let's find it from a model and set it as second control net model. After you checked every setting of workflow at time to run this workflow, before run it, check Comfy UI backend server by click on command window first. It's running. So let's run it by clicking on Q button. It will start processing the images by loading the models one by one, and process will take some time. Now it's time to wait until it's processed. You can see the green line progress in the top bar means workflow is now executing. Maybe it will take around 30 to 40 seconds to get the image as output. So far easy, right? Here you go, now your image is in the output save image node. If you watch the output, you can clearly see that the character anime lady with long ears following the pose of control net and house also generated following my sketch. Even quality is not good. The more sharp image sketch you will provide, it will generate more clear images. You can try it with some other sketches. Already work with three image workflow S. Let's see how to generate text video, and then in the last part one we'll show you how to upscale video. I have some good text to video workflow. Let's open it and check it. Workflow is very simple, have some checkpoint model and clip text encoding prompt and negative prompt. And most important model is SVD model, will help to convert the image to video. I kept one image preview node here, so you will get an idea about image. I provide a text to image prompt where one TV anchor reading the news in a studio. Description is a little bit longer, as it's always better when you want to generate a good quality image, have one negative prompt where you can provide the text which you don't want in the images. Let's set the video model and rearrange the workflow nodes before I run the workflow. Let's click on the cube button to run the workflow. It will take some time as it will process the workflow node by node and generate the image first, then based on that image video will be generated. You can watch the progress in the top bar by green progress bar, or can check by Comfy UI server in the backend command window. Video process needs some time, so wait a little bit. I changed the CFG so it can get better video image. You can play with CFG later. Video can be saved in GIF or MP4 format. Make sure save output is true to save the video. If you like my video, please subscribe and click on bell icon to get notification. Now it's time for the last workflow where I will show you how to upscale an existing video. This workflow is also very simple. You saw when I drag and drop this workflow, one node is showing red border. That means in this workflow, this node needs to install, as this node is not loaded in my Comfy UI server. So let's install the node from Comfy UI Manager. In Manager, check for missing nodes and it will show the missing nodes, and you have to select the node checkbox. And as I have updated version of Comfy UI server version installed, it will ask for the node version that I want to install. I will choose latest version and click on install button. It will again take some time. After a few minutes, it will ask for restart. And after that, Comfy UI server will restart again. It will take some time. And when it's restarted again, click on the refresh button. And after that, if everything is okay and node installed properly, the red border will be gone, in which denote that now you are ready for run the workflow as all nodes loaded. As is a video to video upscale, so we don't need any checkpoint or VA model. Need only upscale model. I will upload some existing short video and try to execute this workflow. Let's upload the video and check all the nodes and settings before I run this workflow. I will make sure upscale model is 4K ultra sharp before I run this workflow. After checked everything, I will run this workflow by clicking on cue button. As is a video for upscale, it will depend on your video size, how long it will take. Small video will be processed faster, and if your video is big and you have less VRM on your GPU, then it will take more time. My video is only 5 seconds video, so hopefully it will not take long time. And here is the output video after upscaled. You can clearly saw the difference. I will provide the links for all workflows in description. Hope you liked the video today. That's all for today. Thank you for watching and like my channel. Please don't forget to share, like, and subscribe my channel.